Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech, and iOS 13.3.1 Beta 1 has been out for a few days. I've been using it primarily on my iPhone 11 Pro Max and some other older devices, but I did run a YouTube community poll where I gathered all of the information based off what you said, and we'll talk about some of the other devices as well. Now, the actual experience that many of you are having is pretty much the same across the board with all of the devices. So if I mention one issue, it covers all of those devices. Now, this update has been okay for me. So in this video, I'm going to talk about how it's been for me, how it's been for you, based off that YouTube community poll. Then we'll take a look at some of the comments. If you want to jump to any point in the video, just look in the description below, and there's some time codes there. You can just jump around to what you'd like to see. Now, the first thing I noticed right away, and it's happened to me about three times, is when I was using FaceTime or the speakerphone, it was actually echoing for the other person. They could hear themselves loudly, so much so that it was difficult for them to actually talk to me. If I used the internal microphone or speaker and microphone, it worked fine. I'm not sure what was going on. It was almost like Apple has multiple microphones activated and they're working improperly. So a few of you said the exact same thing. I'm experiencing that on the 11 Pro Max. Other people are telling me that only when I'm using speaker, but mostly when I'm using FaceTime. Now, I did have an occasional issue switching from Wi-Fi to LTE, but not nearly as much as I normally do. And then I have had a couple slowdowns here and there. So maybe I'll be scrolling and there'll be a little bit of stutter from time to time. That's not very often, but once in a while it does happen. And then that's really it for me on this particular beta. Now, as far as my battery overall, let's take a look at it. I haven't really noticed an issue with it. My battery health is still at 100% on my 11 Pro Max. And over the last few days, well, let's take a look at today. I only used it for an hour and 30 minutes. I've been editing quite a bit, and then 1 hour and 48 minutes of screen off time. And that's not great battery life, probably 5 hours if we used it until I was down to almost zero. If we take a look at yesterday, I had 5 hours and 7 minutes of screen on time, 1 hour and 24 minutes of screen off time, and I used a little bit over 50% of my battery. So that's really what we would expect, about 10 to 12 hours of battery life on the 11 Pro Max itself. Depending on your phone, it's going to be less or more. Now, other than battery life for me, quite a few of you mentioned battery life in the comments on the community poll. In fact, battery was mentioned 44 times out of about 100 comments on this particular poll. Whenever I do a beta, there's always less comments, but there were quite a few votes as well. So we'll take a look at that in a moment. But battery was mentioned 44 times. Many people mentioned freezing issues as well, but mostly it was about battery and it not being great. But a few of you did say it's better. Now, RAM management was actually better in this one. A few of you said you had an issue, but most people say it's great. And then a few people still have issues with mail. And I would suggest removing your mail account and adding it back. I actually haven't had any issues with it right now, thankfully, but quite a few of you have said, well, 11 of you have said that you're having issues with it from time to time, and not really many people having app crashes. And then also not many people having the phone heat up at all this time. Usually when you have a heat issue, that means that the phone's doing something in the background, and I recommend a hard reboot. That's where you would just force it to turn off and boot back up. Now, there were three people that had the same issue as I did with LTE, switching from Wi-Fi to LTE, having it not work properly, but most people seem to have that fixed. Now, as far as all of the devices that were covered in this particular video, here's all the stats on the left. It was less than the previous public release, but like I said, whenever there's a public release, there's far more responses. So here's the device list itself. Now, there's not a whole lot to say about this particular beta, and that's because this was really pushed out to fix the bug with screen time and a few other little bugs. This was not a feature update, of course, being dot one or 3 points out. There's just not a whole lot going on in it. And it's strange that they even made it a beta. In fact, I would expect it to release maybe in a couple weeks, although it's hard to say. Next week is a holiday pretty much across the world in different parts anyway, and they're going to be out of the office, so I wouldn't really expect anything next week. It's possible we could, but I would really doubt it, and probably not until the 6th or so in January. So it's possible we'll see something else, but we don't really know their schedule. Apple doesn't really tell anyone. Now, other than that, let's take a look at the YouTube community poll. Now, with this community poll, It had 12,000 votes, but only 101 comments. This is actually a lot lower than normal as far as comments with 12,000 votes. But either way, I appreciate you commenting and voting. And 18% of you said it was great. 4% said it was terrible. 6% said okay, but some bugs. 57% said I'm using 13.3 or older. So most of you are on the public version. And then 16% of you are using Android. So I appreciate you participating, even though this is all about iOS. Now, out of the comments, let's take a look at some of them. I've read every single one of them to compile the information we talked about a little bit earlier. Now, the first one says 11 Pro, Instagram freezes a lot in DMs, RAM still garbage, everything else is normal. Most people are saying RAM is fantastic, so it may just be the phone, maybe hard reboot it, and then Instagram may need to update their app to fix that. Just glad I'm having no more connection issues, finally. Still having problems with RAM management though, iPhone XS Max. Quite honestly, this update has been great for me. Battery life on my iPhone SE is quite good as compared to iOS 13.3 and previous iOS versions. No issue at all for me. My data speeds have slowed down after updating to beta. I would check your router or modem, or if you're talking about cellular, that could be the amount of usage or traffic in your area. So I would try it a few different times. Battery seems to be improved on 10R and even on 7, not plus, finally. Using iPhone 11 Pro Max and having a lot of cellular connectivity problems. My coworker just got a Samsung Galaxy Note 10 on T-Mobile like me. Right next to each other, he gets 40 megabits per second. My iPhone struggles to get 15. Plus his connection is much more stable. Apple really needs to fix this. And I think you'll see it fixed in the next year's iPhone. And the reason is these iPhones, the new iPhone, since iPhone 10, there are some variants since then that all use Intel modems because of some lawsuits between Intel or Apple and Qualcomm. You'll see that fixed next year as Apple has fixed that whole lawsuit situation and you'll see Qualcomm modems return, which are much better than the Intel modems or have been in the past anyway. Overall, it's great on my iPhone 10, but I've had some issues with my battery life. This has been the best iOS 13 beta yet. Everything runs smoothly and battery life has been great on my iPhone 11 Pro Max. Best battery life on my iPhone 11, usually end the day with 35% battery left with 7 to 8 hours of screen on time. I had it on my iPhone 11 Pro, but I had to downgrade back to iOS 13.3. Weird audio bug while on FaceTime or speakerphone. The caller could hear themselves. The calls were echoing. It's okay on 13.3. And again, I had this exact same issue. Great on my Pro Max, generally great on iPad Pro, but occasionally apps load and only take up 75% of the width of the screen until I reopen them. Random apps. Now that you mention this, I've actually seen this happen on my iPad Pro. So I'm not sure what's going on there, although that's on 13.3, so there's something going on there. The betas turn my battery life of my Series 5 Apple Watch to garbage. Sometimes these updates really affect Apple Watch battery life, and I think you're right. On my Series 4 that I have here, it's at 79% today, but I have seen it drop way down, so I'm not sure what's going on with that. But usually they'll update something, maybe it just leaves it connected too much and they fix it later on. Battery life on my XS is very poor, even though I barely even looked at it yesterday. iOS 13.3.1 beta, FaceTime and phone calls on iPhone 11 Pro Max when talking through the speaker, the other person can hear him or herself echo. And again, just like I said before, a lot of people are having this issue. That's it for iOS 13.3.1 beta 1. It's kind of odd that this is a beta, and I think we'll see a beta probably in the new year, but it's possible they could push one out as early as next week after Christmas, later in the week. I doubt it, but it's possible. It's kind of strange how fast they're pushing out these updates, but I would expect the final release sometime in the early new year. But let me know what you think about it in the comments below. I'll link this wallpaper in the description as I always do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.